Yes, in this video, we are going to see how to the programming implementation of the doubly linked list, that is unordered linked list. When I say unordered linked list, it is nothing but how the data comes in that way you add it to the list. There is no any sorted order. There is no order followed. That is whether it is ascending or descending, that is not followed. So how the data comes, in that way you will be adding it into the linked list. So here, initially we create a node. Yes, by using the structure data type. And then it has a double, since it is a doubly linked list, we have two pointer, one forward pointer and another one is backward pointer. So this is the data portion. And again, those are of node type, which is of the same type. So it is next and previous, both are pointed type. Then we create a class. Declare a class called double LL, that is doubly linked list, and then we declare two pointers. One is to point to the head and another one is pointing the end of the node, that is tail. So this is used to point to the front and this is used to point to the last node. Now we declare a constructor, head is equal to null and tail equal to null. So these two pointers are initialized. It means when both are equal to null, then there is no node in the doubly linked list. So now we have these following member functions: is full, is empty, insert begin. Insert begin will get the data and insert that as the first node. Insert end will insert a node and put this data, and that will be at the end of the node, end of the list. And middle, it will get the location where you want to insert, and then the data also. Then deletion begin, first node will be deleted, last node will be deleted in this deletion end. Deletion middle, given the value, it will search for that value and then it will delete that particular node. So search, it is used for searching that particular data. Then traverse from forward direction, from the first node to last. And here there is reverse traverse, it will traverse from last node to first. Then update, given the old data, a particular node data can be modified with this new data. Then destroy list, it will remove the whole all the node in the particular list. Now so here in useful, which first create a new node, and then if the new node is, if it is able to create, since it is point dealing with the memory, okay, so that in a lot of memory is there. So, but when you create a new node and still you are not able to allocate, means the memory is overflowing. So in that case, naturally the temp will be equal to null, so it returns a one saying that you cannot insert, or else it delete this temporary node and it returns zero, saying that memory space is there for creation of a node and add it to the doubly linked list. Okay, then is empty. Here, if the head is pointing to null, which means no node so far, so in that case it will give you a return one, which means and node is empty, or the linked list is empty, or else it returns zero, stating that there are some values. So these two will be used while inserting and deletion, checking that doubly linked list, whether any node is there or not, or whether any space is there or not. For those, these two will be used. Then insert begin, this data will be given and this data will be taken as the node information field. And then here, see the temp we have given, we have declared a temp, then temp equal to new node, this will create a node which is of type this structure. Okay, where data is there, and before that there will be a previous pointer, after that will be the next pointer. Now here, initially they are made to null, only the data field is filled with the data which you are passing to the function, and then we check for whether there is any node or not. If that is empty, if it is empty, then this will be the first node. So the pointers are accordingly modified. All these theory we have seen already. Then insert n. At the end of the linked list, doubly linked list. So which means what we do is, again we create a new node, place the data, etc. Then we check whether there is any node or not. If no node, then this will be the first node to be in it, or else you have to travel and then reach the tail, that is the end of the node, and then you have to allocate it accordingly. Then insert in the middle. Here what we are going to do is we pass the data and the location where we want. Say, for example, five data, so five nodes are there. We may want to insert it as a third node. So in that case, we will get it as a location. So here we use two pointers, and then we use count in order to count from 1 to 2 till we reach the location. When we reach, that will be the point where we want to insert. So here we create, as usual, we create a new node, place this data, and then we check whether this is the first node. If location equal to 1, then that will be the first node, and we do the modifications of the pointer accordingly, or else it will be in the middle. So then location minus 1, we subtract 1 value, because that place only we are going to insert it. Then current is equal to, that is, we are using a temporary pointer. We move from one node to another node till we reach this. So till either we reach the end of the node or end of the list, or till we reach the real is not location till the count is not equal to location. Then we find out by moving the pointers. Then we count and we go to the correct location where we want to insert, desired location, desired node. Then if check if current node is last node. If it has reached the last, then which means the one which you are going to do is will be the last node. So you make the pointer manipulation accordingly. Else, what you say is index out of bounds. Then deletion begin. We want to delete a value which is node which is present as the first node. In that case, before deletion, we have to check whether any node is there. So that can be done by executing this function. Then we check whether both head equal to null. That means only one node. So if it is there, then we are going to remove that node and then do the modifications accordingly. Then